We're getting bogged now.
Oh,
oh Mitch, come on now.
All right, guys, I'm with Desiree, strength athlete. Hey.
Tell the camera a little bit about yourself.
Desiree, 22. I'm in the military. I've been in about 5 years, just getting back in the gym. It's been about 2 months now.
Yeah.
So, let's get it.
6 month deployment.
Hell yeah.
Big time.
Now I'm back.
Now she's back.
Yep.
Let's go.
Let's get it.
We're hitting chest. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube connected to one thing, and I literally publish it all at once, and I schedule my posts out. So if you look at my calendar, so you can see I've got the next 5 or 6 days already scheduled out. That way you can post on all three platforms, and you don't gotta worry about, like, it's hard to, like, edit and post the same day, you know what I mean? So if you can build them up, get one platform like this, you save so much time. So that's what we do.
Yeah, how long have you been repping strength?
2020?
Yeah, 2020.
Yeah, 2020, like when COVID was like,
yeah,
already in.
Because your name I've recognized a long time through,
yeah,
Instagram and such.
Yeah.
All right, so how do you feel about the ambassador program right now? Because you've been here since 2020.
I think this is the best it's been. It just makes it so much smoother. You have, like, just your monthly, like, oh, here's what you're getting next. And
you're
always repping.
Exactly.
No, so in case, like, you forget or you get busy, like, no matter what, you're gonna have something shipped to you. So
yeah,
it's really nice.
Would you recommend it to a friend?
Oh yeah, 100%.
Heck yeah.
I recommend it like 4 or 5 friends. So.
Big time.
Yeah.
Let's go. One piece of advice for the viewers of this vlog, what would you want to say?
Don't give up.
Don't give up?
No matter what, I mean, life's going to throw you curveballs. You're never going to have it perfect. There's always going to be something that's going to stop you. There's a wall, just climb over it.
There's a wall, climb over it. I love it.
Yeah.
Or blow past it.
Mm-hmm.
Just go right through. One of my favorite books of all time, it's called The Obstacle's the Way by, I think it's Ryan Holiday. Check it out. It's exactly what we're talking about here. But one more thing, just to go off of the social media tip of the metric pool, this just goes to show, like, on Instagram right now, not getting the most reach, but, like, for example, the same video that's currently only at 39 likes on Instagram, posted on TikTok at the same time using that app, this one's at 276 likes. So the more you put yourself out there in different platforms, the easier it's going to be for you to get the exposure you want and hopefully make the impact that you were intending. So that's the tip.
Just got done with the workout with Desiree, and I've been on Snapchat. Those of you that have me on Snap, you know I was asked. I said, what is the best gas station? Because I went to this, it's called Circle K or something like that. And I was like, man, this ain't Quick Trip, right? Because we're from the Midwest, Wisconsin. Now we just moved down to Tampa, literally like 5 or 6 days ago. So it was actually a week now. And, you know, I worked out with Desiree. And then everybody's telling me, wah, 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 wah. So I went to Wawa and I got some food. I want to just show you guys what I think. So this is a frozen coffee regular. Cheers. It's a pretty standard frozen coffee, pretty good. But then we also got the Wawa quesadilla, steak and cheese, steak and chicken cheese.
So I'm gonna try this one for you guys. Try this out. Look at that. Hopefully you can see it okay. That's solid, bro. That's great. The best news for you guys.
One thing I'm really excited about, I'm gonna show you right now.
Something just came in the mail. We got two packages that just came in.
Got a guitar, could open her up. My first guitar. Let's go. Beauty. First guitar. Shout out to Diego for putting me on. Let's go. Yeah, dude, we got a guitar, finally. Who would have thought the boy would be playing a guitar? Yeah, he needs to get tuned.
That was so many reps.
It was like 10 to 12.
Yeah.
Like
hey, I want to feature you in my vlog. So
yeah, 100%.
Plug our supplier.
Oh yeah, Mike Smith.
Mike Smith,
yes,
man.
Yes, sir. Shout out to Mike Smith.
Yeah.
Mike and I connected on Instagram. Shit, man. I want to say like 4 or 5 years ago. We were both trading Forex at the time. So I had a bunch of conversations about that. Just similar mindset, driven, motivated, entrepreneurial. So yeah, shout out to Mike Smith. It's crazy how small the world it is.
It's a super small world. He's referring to our supplier we had for the first 5 years. So absolutely crazy. Mike's a great guy. It just goes to show Midwesterns, we get along.
Yes, sir.
Big time. So let's go.
Sick, bro. Hell yeah, dude. Yeah. You're getting mogged now. Oh, Mitch, come on now. Mitch is an experienced bodybuilder, big time. How has moving down here impacted you?
Dude, honestly, it's changed my life. As far as mentality goes, I really was in a state where I always had a backup plan. I always had that way out, and I realized moving here, there's so many young entrepreneurs that chose not to take that backup, chose to not have a second kind of thing to fall back on, and they're here prospering, making more money they like ever imagined, and then they're also changing lives as well, and it just really motivated me to be like, okay, I'm in this place right now that I want something, but do I really want it bad enough because I have that second plan? I have that thing to fall back on.
That plan B.
Yeah, that plan B. And I really just, I look myself in the mirror and I ask myself one day, like, if this is something that I really want to do, like, you gotta make it worth it. Like,
100%.
Fucking put your all blood, sweat, and tears into it, and it's gonna prosper. But again, just having that fallback plan, you don't put your all into it. Subconsciously, you just are not all in. So as soon as I quit that job, business started taking off, and it's continuing to grow. But that's really what it's about, is just putting your all into something that you love and not having a fallback plan, because I promise you, if you do put that all in, it will happen.
It will.
You will make
it. It has to. You force it to happen.
100%. All of your time and energy goes into the one thing that you're trying to grow and nothing else. So
no distractions.
There's no other option.
No other option but to go up. Dude, hell yeah. That's beautiful.
Just going off of what Hayden was saying, I completely resonate. I was doing insurance at the same time I was trying to run Streignth a little bit with my dad because he sells insurance. I was doing that in 2023, and Streignth wasn't getting the energy and time it needed to really flourish and grow.
For sure.
Talk about you can't have a plan B, right? So we're making it happen out here. Like Streignth, I've talked about it before. We were $100,000 in debt, and you're in this
situation like that, you're really forced to adapt and grow, or you're gonna die. Be screwed. Yeah. We made it out. We're in the green.
Let's go, baby.
Show, like, dude, you have to just. Even the darkest moments, they make you who you're supposed to be.
Yeah.
Look at us now. We're not in a dark moment. We're in a freaking beautiful Tampa.
Let's go.
Area, so, yeah. We'll keep
Hell going. Yeah. Strength to the moon.
Hey, let's go, bro. Got back from the workout with Hayden. That was a blast. Hayden's rep Streignth. He repped us like 2-ish years ago, and he's from the Minnesota area, so it was great to see him. Dude, I was jived with the Midwesterns, I swear. A lot of people I'm noticing that are here are just not from here, which is cool. It's great. Like, everybody here is such good vibes. I can't stress that enough. I'm really thankful for all the people I've met so far. You know, all I do is I work all day. Like, I'll wake up at 7 or 8 a.m. typically, work as hard as I can, and then 12 to 2 or 12 to 3-ish, I've noticed I typically work out, and then I come back and I just work as much as I can. And now
I've been practicing the guitar a little bit too.
So, and then I have a couple meals, so through these vlogs, I wanna share kind of what I eat too. So right here we've got
protein house. I DoorDash this, sweet potato. I've been waiting for my freaking mega to fit meals, dude.
My meal prep kits that I'm sponsored by, I haven't posted about this, but I am sponsored by a company that does meal prep services, so I'll start plugging them in videos like this more. But yeah, they usually ship every Friday, and I got a notification that the shipment got damaged, so I've been DoorDashing everything. It just, yeah. So today I have a chicken, it's a bison steak and chicken wrap.
All right, little update. This is super embarrassing. I don't know if I'm gonna keep this in the vlog. I don't even want to tell anybody this. Oh my gosh, dude, my guitar already broke. I literally had it for 2 days. I was playing it. I wasn't a rage. Don't get me wrong. Don't get the wrong idea. I literally set it in the stand. I don't know if the stand's not put in right, but I turned around and it just fell over. It literally broke. Oh my gosh, dude. No. There's no way. 2 days. Two freaking days, bro.
I didn't get insurance.
Oh, man.
Bro, I don't even know what to say. I'm just distraught. I gotta go to bed.
Dude, I'm just trying to process the fact that that guitar broke. I still don't believe it. Like, maybe it's a sign I'm not supposed to have hobbies besides run Streignth. Because clearly, shit breaks. Whatever. Hey, it's all good. I'll buy a new one, or I don't even know what to do. I'm gonna have to see if I have any kind of insurance. I don't think I do. But yeah, just goes to show, man. Shit happens. That's literally life.
So I want to end this vlog by talking about something my friend Ian Munger mentioned. He says, like, he posted on his story, repping Streignth, wearing a dad hat, running, and he was recording himself talking about how goals come and go, but your standards are who you are. Your standards, if you don't have standards, you have nothing, right? So there are two types of people in the world. The guy who believes nothing matters, and the guy who believes everything matters. And I'll always be the guy, the latter, who believes everything you do has consequences, good or bad, right? You reap what you sow, you must pay the price depending on your decisions. And a huge reason I moved down here, I get asked a lot, why did you move down to Florida? Like, people from up north, people here, it's for the growth of the company, yes. I tell them about Streignth. I'm meeting a lot of people, by the way. I'm probably meeting about 5 to 10 new people per day I go to the gym. But when I'm not at the gym, usually working here with my laptop and getting a lot done, at least for right now, until my friends come down, like Jimmy and such in the next month or so. So the whole plan is to move, hopefully, the business down here in the near future. I can see that happening. But going back to the goals and standard, right? So my standard is right now just dial in, master my emotions. I feel like I've come a long way on that. And just try to look at things as subjectively as possible so I can be the best business owner and leader Streignth needs. Because lot of career revelations since we've been here. Now we're getting into, we're getting into like establishments, let's just say that. In the near future, we have a lot of developments happening on the research side of SUPS. Our training continues to grow. And I want these videos to be an opportunity for you to have a conversation with me. Yes, it's one-sided, but you guys can reach out to me anytime you need anything or comment below. Like, I want you to see me on camera and see me as a friend that wants to help you. And I mean, from what I know, at least, I'm no expert in anything. I've just been running a business for 6 years. Streignth, we're doing about 50,000 a month right now. And I know a thing or two about lifting weights and such. So I want to be there for you. If you guys have any specifics you want to see in these videos too, let me know. Like, comment or reach out to me, because there's a lot more vlogs to come. I like doing these. It keeps me feeling very purposeful. So yeah, like, people might ask me, like, why did you leave Wisconsin? It's like, dude, there's no bad blood. I love Wisconsin. I always say you gotta honor where you come from and never forget it, because the Midwest values especially are, it made me who I am, and I'll always be back. My family lives in Wisconsin. The warehouse is in Wisconsin. And it's not like I was trying to escape anything. I was just trying to get closer to an opportunity for me to grow, right? Being down here, the standard is so much higher. There are some like beautiful people here. Like, all the dudes are jacked, the girls, you know, they're jacked too. And I have no inclination on dating or doing anything like that right now. I'm literally just fully focused on the growth of the company. And I'm so grateful to be here, because I've wanted to be here for over 3 years. We finally made it happen. If I would have came to Florida last year, would have been ready. Even 6 months ago, probably not. But you're never fully ready for anything. But I feel like we're in the right spot right now. Absolutely. We're exactly where we need to be, as are you. And I'm just so grateful for the journey, man. I'm gonna head to bed, got church tomorrow, but thank you guys so much. Like and subscribe. A lot more to come. For real, subscribe if you're not already. All right, see ya.